Well, welcome to today's program. I'm able to visit with Kim Stone, who's the general manager of the Chase Center in San Francisco. Kim, welcome to our show, and how are you doing today?
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be on here. Doing great. Like everybody, just, you know, got my fingers crossed that we get through this sooner rather than later. Yes. But we're all learning to live with it and making progress.
That we are. Now, the Chase Center in San Francisco, you're home to the Golden State Warriors.
Yes.
And a few championships in recent years there. You must have had some crazy times.
They were a lot of fun. 5 straight years, 3 championships during that time. And we're just looking forward to, or I'm specifically looking forward to hearing the ball bouncing again and the cheers of the crowd, hopefully very soon.
Yeah, right now it's over in Orlando, I believe. So
it is. It is. And we were not, just for your audience's knowledge, we were not part of the teams that participated in the restart in Orlando, simply because unfortunately we had lots of injuries to our star players this year. So we were on the outside looking in, but ready for next year.
Next year will happen sooner than we think.
I hope so.
Tell us a little bit about the Chase Center and maybe some of the features there and other types of programs besides basketball that you might have.
Sure. Thank you. So Chase Center is located in downtown San Francisco. It's the first time the city has had an arena in more than 50 years. We opened with great fanfare just last September with an amazing collaboration between the San Francisco Symphony and Metallica, and it was fantastic. And then we went on to have more than 70 events, including shows and games, until we were put into shelter in place in early March. So our last game was actually a Warriors game against the Clippers. So we were open 6 months and then unfortunately had to close down. We do still have some essential staff here working to keep, I call it, we've got the Ferrari in the parking in the garage and we've got to keep it running. So that's what we're doing with our essential staff. But in terms of programming, we're not just an arena. We sit on 11 acres. We have 29 retail restaurant locations, which are in various stages of opening. And we've got 2 Uber office towers that once we're past this, it is anticipated we'll have about 4,000 employees for Uber. So we really call ourselves a campus more than just an arena. But that's the current status. And it's a beautiful facility, state of the art, $1.6 billion to build it. So this is an organization that's always dedicated to world class and first class, and it shows in the type of facility we built. So I can't wait to get fans back in here and let them come back and enjoy live sports and entertainment.
What a place. Quite the venue you have there. I had no idea. So
yes.
Yeah. Now I bank at Chase. Does that mean I get a discount?
Absolutely. We'll talk after this. Yeah.
We'll go offline and figure that out.
Exactly. So we hope all of your audience will as well.
Yes. So Kim, we're going to talk a little bit about the GBAC STAR accreditation for facilities. What was the reason why you decided or your facility decided to go for that accreditation? What were some of the triggers?
I would say that it's about 2 main ones. First and foremost, the thing we do in facility management is keep our crowds safe. So that's being redefined now because safety previously, pre-COVID, was all about physical safety and protecting fans from those threats. Now it's that plus the biological form that we have in terms of the virus. So just we know that coming out of this, we want Chase Center to be the gold standard as it relates to the level of cleanliness, the disinfecting, the sanitation that is so critical to guests and to making sure we create a safe environment for them. The GBAC accreditation confirms that we're adhering to the highest known standards for the cleaning, disinfection, and disease prevention. And coming out of this, that's going to be critical for all of our fans that are coming to Chase Center. So that was number one, right? Making sure that we were affiliated and certified by the world's leading standard in cleaning and disinfecting. We thought that was very important. And then two, just this now makes us hold ourselves accountable to that. And we learned a lot through the process as well and have improved and enhanced all of our protocols as part of this process. So really appreciate what that means. And the end result is we plan to be and want to be the cleanest, safest facility for both fans and artists and teams. Mm-hmm. You know, the quality of people we have and coming through here, it's important we keep everybody safe.
Yes. So your staff is aware of the accreditation. Now your visitors, those who come for your events, may not be. What will this mean for them?
Oh, well said. You know, GBAC, although, you know, highly regarded and certainly the gold standard in the industry, we're going to do a lot of marketing and education of our fans and our staff. It'll start with our staff when they return to the office, and then it'll just flow from there. This becomes part of the brand. It becomes part of the story that we tell about Chase Center. It's a very important part of the story. And so we feel like the GBAC was the right partner to help us create that narrative coming out of COVID. Mm-hmm.
So there are 20 elements to become accredited. Could you pinpoint some of the most challenging parts of that for your facility?
Element 7 had to do with risk assessment and risk mitigation. And I really applaud GBAC because that had us redefine and enhance, you know, what we call risk. And so just through that process alone, it had us adjust a lot of our protocols. It had us, again, refine and enhance what we consider a risk, and helped us educate us about what procedures and protocols we needed to put in place. So that was probably the greatest learning for us, which means that it was one of the hardest for us. You know, we're fortunate because we're a new facility. Again, as I said, we haven't even been open a year. And so what that means is all of our cleaning protocols and policies are brand new. And I have a world-class arena operations team that created these policies and procedures. And so in the cleaning area, we already were cleaning to the highest standards, but there's a difference between cleaning versus disinfecting and sanitizing. And so GBAC, through the process with GBAC, you all helped us because we already had great protocols and policies. For example, we had electrostatic sprayers that were sourced as part of our opening. And when everything was happening, we were already using electrostatic sprayers prior to being put into shelter in place, because that's just, again, I go back to the high standard that we have here. But that specifically element 7 helped us redefine and enhance and understand what strategies we need to do to mitigate our risk.
Yeah. I was going to ask you what was the easiest part of the process, but I think you might have just answered it there. You were prepared. You had the equipment, and you had a good team behind you. Would you add anything to that?
No, I think you've nailed it. It comes down to those things. And so we're fortunate because I think it was an easy enhancement of our protocols and policies, and we're all new to Chase Center, and we're all new, and we created these policies and protocols. So it was easy for us to pivot because we knew them extensively. And so we're fortunate, you know, and just again, to your point, world-class building, amazing team, and new policies and protocols for us. So I couldn't be more thrilled.
Yeah, I bet you are. Tell us, is there anything that with this process of accreditation that you're now doing differently that you'll continue on in the future, even past the pandemic?
Yes, I think it's the protocols and policies for this disinfecting and sanitizing to the level that you kill an infectious disease, right? That's just that next level. And so, you know, those specific, you know, tactics that we'll do, I love the training component, the staff training component that comes along with GBAC certification, and the extra we can actually, you know, send our staff to get certified. And that's just making our cleaning folks experts in mitigating disease and infection. And so I think that's been critical. And I think for us, and for me in particular, I just appreciate the opportunity to partner with a group that really is helping us achieve even a higher standard, again, for safety. That's what we do, is keep people safe. And this is an important piece of that.
Right. Yeah. When the pandemic's over, we can't let our guard down. We have to keep fighting. Yeah.
Yeah. This reminds me of 9/11 and what happened with security protocols and the enhancement that came and evolved from that. The same thing is happening here. And we're ready for it. And I'm fortunate, again, the Golden State Warriors, just it's in our DNA to do everything at a world-class level. And I'm fortunate that that's the plan coming out of COVID. And so that philosophy applies to the facility and applies to our team.
Mm-hmm. That's right. My last question is this one. If someone in a similar position as yours, another venue, were to ask you, should we do the accreditation with GBAC STAR, what would you say?
I would say yes. And I've had people actually call and ask me why we chose GBAC. And to me, it's just that opportunity to take a deep dive and look at your processes, your procedures, and your policies, and really refine them and enhance them. And it's little things. It's not a big leap for facilities of this level to pivot and evolve in this area, because we already do that. It's part of who we are. All of the NHL, NBA facilities and the other arenas and facilities that are going for this, we're already operating at world-class level. So this was just an enhancement. And I think I would say to anybody, an arduous and rigorous process, but it's worth it in the end because you become better from it. And that's what we all strive to do, is become better. And I think GBAC really helped us meet the challenges, because you all educated us about what disease and infectious disease prevention means. You taught us additionally about risk mitigation as it were in this area in pandemics. And so it's just, you've been a great partner to help us understand how to meet this challenge and how to continue to keep our fans safe.
Well, Kim, thank you for your time today, and the Chase Center, the success it is, will continue, and hopefully we'll be full of fans really soon.
Thank you, Jeff. I appreciate it. Best of luck to you guys, and please come visit us when we're on the other side of this.